Hey man, how you doing? Good to see you, man.
How you doing, brother?
Hey guys, real quick, thank you all the guys for coming. Thank you for the manpower that's coming. You guys have been awesome. Thank you for you young people that showed up. For the parents that are here, 25 showing up, so you guys can know. 25 of our young people showed up, signed up. 25 confirmed yesterday. We all control what we can, correct?
That's right.
We all can control what we can. If they'd have told us that yesterday, say, hey, 25 would show up, we wouldn't be here today. But guess what? We're here, and we're going to make it happen for these guys because they deserve it, right?
That's right.
So I thank you guys for sharing. What we'll do a shortened version of what we're here to do today for them. Okay, so we'll do a shortened version for the staff that's talking about, our team that's talking about safety and hand signals. Let's do a shortened version of that so we can get them on these bikes and do the cycling course. And then what we'll do for the ones that are here, I'll have them get more quick and cook those burgers for you guys so they'll be ready so we can do a shortened version to feed you guys and get you out and have something to cook. Then I want to have a brief discussion about how do we market better, how do we get this out to these babies better. Like I was sharing with so many of those that are here, and I believe in my county, I trust the people. Turn that dial down for me. Yeah, it's far right left. And I want my young people to hear this and hear me well before the adults are in the room. And this is a strong conversation. Everything cannot be for free.
Yes, sir.
Okay? Because what happens, you see a result of this today. You see a result of this today. We're in an unhealthy community. This is promoting healthy exercise. But at the end of the day, and people ask me, they say, hey, give away book bags with it. This is about exercise and healthy living. This is not about giving school supplies away and all that good stuff. We do too much of that in our county. Hear me and hear me well. Young people, you've got to earn your way through life.
Yes, sir.
You have got to earn your way through life. Don't expect anybody to give you everything. You've got to work for it. And so adults that are in the room, if that mindset don't change, you will fail. You will fail. And so as a leader, this gives me new insight. This gives me new insight. So we do it for them. Guys, let's go ahead and do hands. So give them a watered-down version of let me back up. Let's introduce everybody in the building so you guys will know who they are. Okay? I'm the sheriff of Edgecombe County. Glad to see you guys. Thank you guys for being here. I appreciate you guys. Okay, we'll start right here. Just want to introduce yourself so you guys will know who's in the room. Okay, let me get you and we'll come back over here. Yeah, come on up. Yeah.
I'm Trooper Garrett. A lot of y'all met me. You gonna leave me hang?
Yeah. Did she get up? She gonna get up.
So I'm Trooper Garrett. I help you guys get y'all helmets today, okay? A little bit of advice. Remember, when you get it, you're gonna loosen it up because you want to take it off. But also, remember, you got to be level with your head. Over your forehead.
You just gonna start talking. Okay.
Wait a minute. Sharon's gonna get him. Well, I already got y'all, okay?
I'm not the only one that can get him in the I said, do what I said.
How you say it?
I said, tell who you are.
My name, my mama named me Joe McGann. Control called me Drew McGann. And most people call me JJ.
I'll come back to you. That's what you get.
All right. All right.
I already told you. You just say something. We're gonna come back to you. Yes.
Everybody woke now.
Kelvin Dickens, Matt Tillery, Haywood Parker.
Brianna Storm Baker.
Donald Fox.
James Curtis from the Rockman Telegram.
Leah Porsche. Let's come back here, guys.
Yeah. Elmo Woody Man Sorrow.
Kurt Cooper.
Robert Wilson.
Spine Floor SRO.
I'm basically SRO.
Lady Sproul SRO.
Where's the whitehead?
Ivory Jones.
Come on back up here, Troop. look, come on back up.
Sure.
Wait, no man saying nothing. Y'all gotta say something.
You jump.
Richard Dillon, SRO.
Joe Copia, SRO.
Eric Fox, SRO.
Good deal. Hey, look, I want to thank all you guys for your and we'll chime in. This is family. We want you young people to engage in conversation. Any one of GCC want to talk about staking real quick. In conjunction, I know you want to talk about the heaven state. So you already jumped on a little bit. Come on back up. We want to talk helmet safety and just safety, and we're just going to chime in just for you guys, okay?
Since I've already gave my goofy side of my personality. So you guys, like I said earlier, you guys are going to take your helmets off. You're going to put your helmets on. So you got to realize, you got to understand how to put it on properly, okay? So you want it to be level with your head, over your forehead, at least a 2-inch space in between your eyebrow, okay? And make sure that it's tight. The chin strap is tight, and a lot of you guys have back straps that is able to loosen and tighten up. Make sure you get that tight as well, okay? Anybody else from the cycling group want to chime in?
Sounds good, bro.
And plus, I'll be here all day, and any one of these guys, gentlemen and ladies in here can help you guys as well, okay? If you guys have any questions, please feel free to ask. Parents, same thing, okay? Because they're going to come to you guys for guidance too when they forget.
Good morning again.
What we're going to do right here is basic hand signals.
Basic hand signals. This is your left.
This is your right. And this is stop. And anytime you communicate with each other, you know, somebody, if you're riding in group 2 or 3, if you're going to make a left turn, say left. Say verbally so they can hear you. You're going to make a right turn, say right so they can hear you. And stop. Just basic hand signals.
And let me share some stuff that Kirk. Cycle 10 Keto for a second. Come to me for a second.
So let's just say Kirk is in the front gate. We're going to be in the line so you guys can really pull the full scale.
This line up behind him. And so basically, we're going to pump a little bit more, Kirk.
Go up all the way up to the S. Yeah, that's good.
So basically, when we're lined up in formation, we're riding on the road. When we're riding on the road, if I'm the last person, give me a front hand signal, just you alone, Kirk, by yourself. I may not can see that. Actually, I can't see that right here riding the bike. I got on goggles and we're riding. But if everybody give a hand signal, I can see something that's going wrong or something's happening. Okay? So that's why it's important for everybody to give hand signals, because if I'm in the back and I'm behind this tall guy and I got my helmet on and I'm riding, I can't see, but guess what? If he gives signals, so Kirk, go all the way hands up with a stop. So guess what? If I'm in the very rear, this one to read, if I'm in the very rear, if their hands are all the way up, look, I can see all this. It's up to everybody to give hand signals, not yes. So I don't care what you do. If you do any kind of movement off the handlebars, I see all it. And it's for this, it keeps people in the rear. So you got to understand, we're running 20 and 25 deep, and it's 25 of us on the road. They've got to get signals in the front before we see. And guess what we do a lot of? So if we're going to make a left turn, let's just say, if we're going to stop the guys, what are we all saying?
Stop.
And we're loud. So it's got to be like those cars are passing. So hey, we're loud. If we're going to make a left turn, guys, what are we going to say?
Left turn.
We're loud. And so not only are we utilizing, but we're talking to each other. If we see a rock in the road, what are we saying? A debris.
Debris.
And we're pointing to it. So that's a sign, yeah, we're pointing to the debris in the road. And that's so, and guess what? If Kirk sees debris in the road, make a movement, Kirk. If you see debris, what do you move? Move.
Yeah.
Debris.
And guess what it does to all of us? Yeah, it makes all of us move. Okay? If Kirk sees, we're coming up to railroad tracks, what are you saying, Kirk?
Slowing tracks. Slowing.
And it gets all the way back to me. And guess what? We all come out off the seat. Because if you hit railroad tracks, we're coming off the seat. Okay? So this is what this looks like when you're cycling with a big group. Because we're all communicating with each other. Brothers, anything else? I'm done. Anything else? That is a down version. That is a watered down version of what you guys may see. Guess what? We have a good time. Courtney's in the back. Where are you? Hey, Courtney. Dr. Whitehead is in the back. They are on the Edgecombe County cycling team, which is a bike patrolling area. And so they do a good job of coming through neighborhoods and keeping us safe. And of course, all our SROs who you guys are going to see are in your schools this year, okay? And I'm trying to give y'all the quicker version. So, we got a bike helmet trooper. Can you tell us an enforcement standpoint, how many cyclists do you see injured a year or do? I know this is putting you on a cold spot, but what you've seen in your career, cyclists being hurt and things of that nature?
Throughout my 17 years, most of mine are, you guys are in the rural county, so we see a lot more in our inner cities because we got a lot more people cycling in our inner cities. When we get into our county areas, we have a lot of cycling teams that actually cycle. But for you guys, what I'm going to tell you guys, numbers, I can't give you a number or percentage right off the top. But for you guys, it's almost like driving. You guys are driving a vehicle, but just not motorized, okay? You have to look out for you and other vehicles in the roadway because they're sometimes not paying attention. So you guys got to pay attention too, okay? So stick to the hand signals that they gave you, because as a motorist, as a driver, as me being an adult and driving, we have to recognize those signals too. We have to know what those signals are as well, so we can be prepared to stop when you guys are stopping, okay? But just make sure when you guys are riding in your neighborhood, in your community, when y'all see that stop sign, make sure you stop at that stop sign as well, because you have to follow those laws too when you come to those stop signs in your neighborhood, all right? We track it. Because I don't want to have to come and get y'all a ticket. Oh, no, I'm going to get y'all a parent ticket. Yes, sir.
You give them direction to travel also?
Yeah. So also with that too, you have to flow with the traffic. So if you're going north, if this car is going north, you have to travel north with the two. You can't go against the traffic, okay? Like most time you see people running. Most time they say walk against traffic. But when you're on your bicycle, you got to go with the flow of traffic as well, okay? That makes sense? Yes, ma'am.
So I take a lot of these little, we ride around town, downtown. As a parent, I know, like, it's just go with the flow of traffic, but it's tempting to take them on the sidewalk sometimes just because they're so young. Is it okay to ride your bike on the sidewalk?
So a lot of times, I'm a turn it over to with that question of cycling. A lot of times it fall on that city code or that county ordinance, like so what do they have there? So it's based off the city. Like, I'm around the Raleigh area. In Raleigh area, no, because a lot of the cities in Raleigh, they have bike lanes, so you have to stick to the bike lane.
And can I ask you a question? You talking about, like, that little baby right there?
No, she's in a bike seat with me. Okay. She'll be with me.
So my answer to you is yes, right on the sidewalk. Okay. They're too young to react.
Right.
I'm saying this straight as a parent,
right.
Politician, however you want to say it. They're too young to react on the street. So guess what? You ride those babies on the sidewalk.
Because a lot of cars aren't very...
Yeah. You ride them on the street. They cannot react the way that we can on the street. I mean, sometimes our cars are at bikes, they need to get back on. And Dave Cruz ride with us as well. So Dave ride with us. Can I share it?
I'm a bad person to ask about bikes.
I love it. Okay, hey, guys, come back for a minute. But Dave rode with us again. I just want to show you guys something real quick. We start talking about communicating and talking, even when you ride with your parents and mama. But you got to talk, okay? So when we ride the double up, so and this may happen. I may be the eyeball out. Courtney, come here.
Come here for a second.
So I may be the eyeball out, but we always have front captains, middle people. We all communicate. A lot of us in the rear, but let's just say, for example, we're riding 8 deep. So when we're riding 8 deep, we take control of the lane. Mm-hmm. We take control of the lane, unless it's heavy traffic, and we'll go back single file. So if it's heavy traffic, we'll go back single file. But it's easier for cars to see us when we're taking up the whole lane. People get upset. They get upset, like, man, y'all in the middle of the road. But guess what? The whole thing is sharing the road. So it's easier for people to see us when we're riding in the middle of the road. So if Kevin is up front, and we'll make ready to make a left turn, we may be on a 3-lane road, or we may be ready to make a left turn on Bounder Farm Road. That is my call from the back. You know why? Because they're pushing it. My call is from the back is to look back, make sure cars are not behind us, because we're going to make a left turn. So guess what? If me and Courtney is not aware, if we're not paying attention, and we let them know cars back, stand by, don't move. Cars passing, we're always talking. So me and Courtney see that it's clear for Kevin and Kurt to make a left turn, then we'll be that line change, and we'll all move together. And then we'll all move left turn together. So we're always talking. So when you guys are riding, make sure you guys are always talking. Can you guys do that? Thank you. So that's the short version of it. Let me bring Ricky up. SRO Dozier. He does a great job of setting our course up. And you guys are salespeople. So next year we have this again. This is good because we honor you guys. You guys are selling this for us. SRO Dozier does a great job. We've been doing this, I don't know, setting up courses, and it seemed like 25 years. So we've been doing this a long time. He's just become a master of it. So the course that you'll see now, down that you guys are going to do, and let's just say, Ben, this small number, I want them to run through twice. Okay? I want y'all to run through the course twice. SROs, you guys be vigilant. Make sure they don't get hurt. Encourage them, uplift them. Like in the team, make sure you guys are the courses. I know you're going to be moving, taking pictures there with us. But make sure you're visible, and then we just got a lap around and make sure you guys are in your spots with cars and traffic. Okay. So if you speak to us briefly, that's about what they're going to see in a little bit, okay?
Okay. All right, what we're going to see is a bunch of courses. It's not just a obstacle course. It's like a skills course. It's going to test your skills and stuff, too. Also, bike safety, using your signals. Verbal, you know, there's going to be cars sitting out there, sitting out when you come to the intersection, you know how to stop at the stop sign or intersection using your signal. But what we're going to do, I'm going to demonstrate, once we go out, we're going to demonstrate, we're going to have somebody, Ms. Courtney, she's going to demonstrate the lane for you, so we're going to walk out and tell you exactly how to do it so there's no more confusion. Also, there's going to be somebody at each station that's going to tell you exactly what to do. It's nothing hard, it's just some people are a little bit more experienced riding bicycles than others, and that's what we're here to do. Make sure your brakes are working on your bike. That's a real big plus for you. If your brakes are not working, everything's in proper condition. You know, your seat is the right height. You know, you're not on the bike that's too big for you, where your feet can't touch the ground. You should be able to stand with your feet flat on the ground without being on the seat. Or on the seat, if you like. But without being on the seat, both feet on the ground, without having to have one leg cocked up just so you can hold your balance. You should have both feet flat on the ground. So we got a couple courses where, with a quick lane course, when we first go out, it's going to be able to maintain lane control. You got to learn to stay in your lane like we was talking about. You want to get on the sidewalk instead of on the street. But you got to learn to, because some people may say, well, you can't ride on the sidewalk. It's too busy. So you have to learn how to maintain lane control. So that's going to be the first course when we start out here. Also going around the curve at the same time. Then we're going to have a quick decision. Because you don't know, sometimes you may have to go left, you might have to go right at the last moment. So that's going to be a course. When you enter, there's going to be someone standing there and tell you which way to go. You just go the direction that they point. That's going to be a real quick decision. Always there's debris or something in the road. So you got to go over a course where how to maneuver over obstacles in the road. Zigzag, in and out. You know, we all like to do that. Zigzag. You know, we Richard Petty on bicycle. figure eight. Everybody know what a figure eight is? What? There you go. We got it. So, but once we get down here, we're going to show you exactly what to do. So I don't need to tell you everything. So we're going to show you the course. We're going to walk outside. We're going to walk through the course real quick. And I have somebody demonstrate the course so you know exactly what to do. Okay?
Thank you, sir. Let's give a round of applause. Thank you. Look, this is still great. Here's what we're gonna do. I just talked to Good Company Cycling. That's what GCC stands for. A lot of these guys are good company. They're retired, just like my SROs. It's okay, baby. Just like this, I got you. You got down there a little quicker than I could, though, baby. You guys are a good company in those green shirts. That's why you guys work for the ASO County Sheriff's Office. You guys serve this company. Part of the reason we call ourselves a good company, you have retirees. You have retired Social Act, you said actively working. But Mr. Forsyth is retired first sergeant with the Highway Patrol. Matt is retired captain with the Rocky Mountain Fire Department. Donald works, he still works hard, makes a whole lot of money. Rob works at the Eastern County Sheriff's Office. He's a retired Colorado Police Officer, retired New York State Trooper, retired Edgecombe Sheriff's Office, retired Lieutenant Ed Bike, retired Lieutenant, retired Chief of Police in Prestonville, Fox, retired, I like to call him lead SO sometimes, retired there off the Hillwood. So all of us in here are good company. Of course, you're still active, big guy. I watched him grow up. I don't know if you took some of that energy from me or not, but that's a high energy. But I wish we had more state law enforcement, just like, okay? You guys don't know what that feels like to have a state trooper in the room, because you rarely get outside of that Class A uniform, and he's able to do that. He's able to get outside of that space of just giving somebody a ticket. So anytime, brother, that you are welcome with your energy, I appreciate you coming in here. Here's what we're going to do for you guys. Raise your hand if you love being a kid. Here's what we're going to do for all you guys, because we're going to honor all of you guys. When you guys leave here today, we're going to get you a hamburger. We're going to make this a short today. When you guys leave here today, Good Company Cycling, you guys follow us to Walmart, and we're going to buy every one of you guys a brand new bike today. So, when you guys leave, parents, when you guys leave, we have time. And sometimes it's time to make children happy. We don't discuss fun. You guys see us walk out. We walk out and we make a decision in 30 seconds. And that's the kind of leader I am. I don't have time to sit out day long and discuss things and come back the next week and do all that stuff. Either we're going to do it for you guys or not. So today, on behalf of Good Company Cycling and all these guys that are behind us today, and we'll make a decision. Some want to go to Walmart, some of them leave, and some we'll figure it out. But we're going to let you guys pick up the bike of your choice today. Okay? Is that okay? Yes. So what we're going to do,
I need to sign up.
Yes, sir?
I need to sign up.
You need to sign up? All right, so what we're going to do now, put your helmet on, grab your bike if you have one, and be the sign up.
I'm signing up so I get that free bike.
Hey, Lieutenant, let's have some food ready for about an hour. Vertebrae. I bet everybody that's out here.
They gonna go down there, but
okay.
We're gonna start right here. Thank you.
they more hard.
Oh, yes, sir. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Right.
Hey, how many?
I don't know what it's going to get like this in.
I think in the 80s.
Oh, that ain't bad at all.
When they come around that corner, make sure they stop at that stop sign right there.
All right, how we doing, man? All
right.
I got a good offense. Right.
Ain't they supposed to go around those spots? That one right there, point back some.
Man?
No. This one in the land right here covering the whole land. Put it which one way or the other. Go. Yeah, that's cool.
Problem,
mm-hmm. Belt game, I mean, tank game on, yeah.
I can go either way. I don't see nobody at this post. I can go either way.
Stay in your lane.
Good job.
That's fine, that's fine. All right, quick decision. Watch me. There you go. All right, all right. Good job. Come on, real fast, right here. On the feet.
Hey, Dollar. He said, watch my hand.
Come back. When this thing hits. Hey, look.
There you go. Debris in the road on the right.
Three.
Okay.
Right six.
Set them in that corner.
You saw that big
All right, yeah, I got my.
We can start getting these up.
Captain Cofield, where's that car?
Let them know which way you come on.
Hey, wait.
What you do here?
Want all the bikers down here?
Thank you.
crazy. Crazy.
Good job, good job. Awesome, awesome. Good job, pal. Good job, Daniel.
I'm holding and waiting for the next instruction.
With the cones?
Yeah.
We're doing speed now.
Don't hit Fox, James.
Thank you.
All right, all right.
Coming in.
Hey, sir. Sir.
It's gonna take off. It's coming. It's probably gonna be 5 minutes coming.
Okay. It ain't gonna be 5 minutes.
Come on up here.
Yep.
I gotta let them get back though.
Hold on up here.
Hey, Donna, how old is he?
He's
an eight, but he's gonna be with number four, number seven. Go.
Oh. That's your baby. You
okay?
Good job, good job. Good job.
Good job. Yay. Hey, y'all better than that. Two matter winners.
Junior, all right, Junior.
And he finished.
Okay. There you go,
Junior. Get your bike.
Good job. Yeah, good all right, get your bike, get your bike. We got to take them out and get your pictures.
Good job, guys.
He should be the fast guy.
Well, come over here.
Frank, come over here. Come over here with your bike. Come over here.
We ain't done yet. We ain't done yet.
You all right?
I'm good.
Here, I got you one.
Come over here, guys. Come on, gotta get your picture, guys. Come on, hey Sheriff, come over here, baby. Gotta get your picture over here.
Come on, babe. Come on, get your picture.
Right here, right here.
Looks like
Jello.
Come
on, who's in Farmville?
Farmville,
come on, baby.
Farmville,
come on, baby.
Take your hat off and put
your medal on. Take your hat off and put your medal on. Number four. Come on, baby.
Yes, you know, that's
equal. Put your medal on so you can take the picture.
Back up. You got to take it home.
Back up. We're going to get the camera. Back up. He's right here. Don't get that gentleman right there.
Take your helmet off. Put your medal on.
Put your medal on.
Good job.
Hey, y'all look at Rocky Mount Telegram and then look at this guy.
Thank you.
All right, back in the class.
Okay.
Hey, wait.
Okay.
Come on, you
two
back.
Good job.
Ready?
One, two, three.
Look at Tammy first. Look at Tammy. Okay, now look at me.
Mr. Penn's got water.
Phone booth.
I'm in it. Did we get one? All right, everybody in the class. Right, I think number eight. Somebody missed
number eight. Right here. Number eight and three.
What, the gold medal?
No, he didn't take his picture. He had
to. Eight and three need to take a picture.
Number eight. Come this way.
Get your bike and go stand in the class for me.
Bring your bike.
There you go. I like that. I like that.
He's right. He won.
Okay.
Come on, right here.
Put your helmet on. Put your helmet on. Put your helmet on. Not wrong with
Foster. No, I'm the big.
Can you put it back on?
Yeah, put it on the back.
I mean, he's going to go. We're just going to go relay. Good job, fellas.
Good work, good work.
Okay. You good?
Okay,
so we
got
here
we
go.
We
got
seven. Okay. Y'all look here.
One, two, three.
Okay, guys, over here. All right, right here, guys. You ready, baby?
Yeah.
Come on.
Hey, you know the family. Remember the law. We can go right at it.
I need everybody to come up to the line.
Lights out.
Lights out.
So, Rick,
I know that's right.
You were one.
Get my system back.
You were two. Listen up.
Oh, yeah. It's me and right now.
All the ones go to Mr. Doty. All the ones right here.
Yeah.
I don't care what your game plan is. You want the oldest to go first. But I need you to line up in the way that you're going to go in the relay. Y'all on the relay team. Line up, how you gonna go? Get your
game ready. Matt, are you listening, man?
Hurry up, you got to go, man. All right, we gotta line up behind each other. Who's second? How do y'all want to go? Line up your bikes. I need y'all a team.
He got it.
Watch out, baby. Be careful,
buddy. I'm in the
Y'all go ahead. Y'all do it. We're gonna get a group picture right here when we're done with them.
I know.
Let's go! Where's the weight going?
Come on.
Where's the other one?
There's an item.
hand together.
I'm good.
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good.